Years. Now we are talking about fire and safety. So what is fire? As you know that what is fire, so which elements they are contributing to fire, ignite or start or to continue. So what are those elements? Here there are four elements. You see in majorly three elements only. So in this tetrahedron, at the outer side there are three elements are presented. So in the center is chemical reaction. So what are these three elements outside of this tetrahedron? So first one is fuel. Whatever the fuel, maybe a liquid fuel, solid fuel, or maybe a gaseous fuel. And second one is oxygen. So absence of air, because air contains an oxygen quantity, so oxygen. And the third one is heat. Sufficient quantity of heat is not available, then there is no fire. Sufficient quantity of the oxygen, that is air, is not available, then also there is no fire will come occurs. And fuel, sufficient quantity of fuel is also available, not available, then there is no fire. If these three elements together, then fire starts. If you are supplying continuously, then fire also comes continuously. If you remove any one of this element from this triangle, then automatically fire will comes down. So this is what we call fire tetrahedron. So mostly we call it as a fire triangle. In fire triangle, these three elements are very very essential to know to extinguish the fire with the help of reduction of the fuel, or maybe removing the oxygen, that means by providing the CO2 with the help of fire extinguishers and heat. Okay. Okay, see here there are classes of fire: A class, B class, C class, D class and K class. So this is K class is recently updated, that is recently they are given this priority. So in for cooking also there is some fire is happening because of the oils. So this, because of that one, they are classified as a K, kitchen fires. So what is A class fire? That is solid combustibles, maybe like timber, any hydrocarbons which are in the form of solid state, that is what solid combustible fire, that is A class fire. B class, hydrocarbons and alcohol based liquids and gases, that is B class. Hydrocarbons generally we call it as, maybe we call them petrol, diesel, CNG, here alcohols, so whatever may be the gases or maybe liquids. And C, energized electrical equipment. C class fire, sometimes maybe fire because of the short circuit, at that time also there is a fire will occur, that is a C class. And D class, flammable metals. Some of the metals, they are flammable. If we leave it for a longer time, then it causes flame. Okay, so these are the, and the last one is K class, that is a kitchen fires. So as I discussed before, we are starting this class of fire. So hot pan or maybe oils where you are using to for the cooking purpose, that is K class fire, that is K class fire. So how we can prevent the fire? So here you see, assess the potential fire hazards, find ways to reduce risk of starting of a fire, find ways to reduce risk of injury also. So what are the fire prevention includes? Educating the workers, because if the worker don't know what kind of fire which is happening, instead of using one extinguisher, he used another extinguisher, maybe fire will not come down. Generally we can reduce the fire by the initial stage only. If it crosses the limit, then you cannot control the fire, then it causes very big loss. So before we have to enter into the industry, we have to educate the workers to know about the fire prevention system, limiting the ways of fire can start. So by removing the whatever the in fire triangle, what are the elements they are presented, remove the any one of the element, then automatically fire can limiting the injuries. obviously whenever you are talking about the prevention, definitely there will be limit of injuries. Preparing for workplace for fire disasters. If any time the fire will happen, you have to handle the firefighting equipment like high pressure equipment, pumps and hoses, how to reel out and how to make up the nozzle, everything in a systematic manner. Whenever there is a fire, so we have a prevention plan. Unless we don't have a plan how we can execute and how we will save our people and our environment and our equipment. So company must develop a fire prevention plan. The plan must cover potential fire hazards, procedures for fire prevention, fire evacuation plans. Plan must be in writing and available to workers. Workers should know who are the members they are in the team. So in a fire, in case of fire happens, the people should together form like a five people with a one leader. They will rescue and they will take care about the what is the incident is happening inside the field. And how to fire extinguish? Fire extinguishers eliminate elements of a fire. Tetrahedron. If tetrahedron is broken, fire will go out. Additional cooling and water may be necessary. So finally, what I am trying to tell is, so whenever you see fire, don't be panic. So inform the who are the supervisors in the around you or maybe people who are around you, and don't get panic. And if possible nearby you, then start operating the alarm and go to the master point and inform the all the people before you are going. As well as you have to take care about yourself first, then you have to rescue if anyone is fall down. Unless until you don't know how to do the rescue, if you are doing rescue, then it causes very severe damage to the people who are in the risk. Okay friends, I hope you understand well. So if you like my video, please subscribe. Thank you.